Hello everyone, in today's video we are going to show how a simple password protected exe file can be cracked. Okay, so basically we are doing a reverse engineering on this particular crackme.exe file, and we will show you how we can bypass the authentication. So once we click in this application file, we can see that it is asking for username and registration code. Okay, let us suppose give some arbitrary value. If we check it, it is popping up bad boy. Nope, that's not it. Try again. So we have to analyze it. So we have seen that if we giving an arbitrary value, it is popping a wrong message. So for reverse engineering this, we have to disassemble this file. For debugging this file, we will use a software which is known as X32 debugger. So we have opened our X32 debugger. Just we will drag and drop this exe file into our debugging menu. We can see that some assembly level code has come in front of us. Okay, so we have to analyze this code. But one thing, when we launch that application file giving some arbitrary value, we have seen a wrong pop-up message, that is, nope, that is not it, correct again or try again. So we have to find that string and why this string is coming. So right click on this menu and search for all modules string references. We can see that this string has been coming here. So click on that and follow in disassembler. We can see that after this particular operation, this string is coming. Let us analyze this code once again. Here, user is giving a registration code, and the program is taking the registration code and it is comparing to a particular memory location with a particular memory, with the particular value of the code that is stored in that location. And if this is correct, a command is passing jump not if not equal. If this password is comparing, it is correct, it will show that is good boy, and if it is not correct, that is, it will show a bad boy on this string. So we can see that after pushing this to memory location, this jump statement is coming. So if we can modify this jump statement to a particular memory location which will always execute, then we can bypass this authentication. So we have to modify this line. So let assembly and particularly we have to patch up this. Suppose we will not use jump if not equal, we will use jump to a arbitrary memory value, suppose BE. So we have successfully make a manipulation in this code. So let's patch it. Patch file, and we will save it, suppose cracked.exe. See, our file has been patched. So now open this file. See, we are getting the same thing. Okay, let's try with that arbitrary value. See, now the purpose has been changed and it is bypassing. What we are getting? Yep, that's the right code. Go write a key gen. See, the authentication has been bypassed, but we do not have the correct registration serial number. Means we are bypassing with some arbitrary value because no authentication is doing here. We have cracked it. So we have to find the correct value which will not give some arbitrary value, will give some perfect value which is stored in that memory position. So let us find it. Okay, so we have to open again that uncracked version. We have opened it and again we will search for the string. See, we have found out the string. And let's again the similar process we will follow into disassembler. See, when we are getting this pop-up, bad boy, nope, that's not it. We are seeing that two memory location has been pushed. We are pushing some two memory locations. And we are seeing that either of these two memory location, 406549 and 406949, it have to contain some password, because these two memory location is being comparing with the password that we are using from the user. So in one of the memory location might we get the password. So let's change this instruction value to this instruction that we can get a string here. So let's change this to 406549 and let's see. Okay, in both the position. So we have changed this memory location value to both position. Okay, let's see what's happened now. We will patch this file and newly name keygen2. See, we have made some successful patches here. Let's see if this time it's work or not. But let me check one time. See, we are getting some arbitrary value here. Okay, so let us try with this value now. So this was our previous file crackme.exe. Now we will log in with the same registration code we have obtained here, 356909141439. You can see that is the right code, and we have not cracked this time, but we are securing with some successful registration code. So you can see by this way we can do a reverse engineering on a simple APK or exe file or any kind of Linux executable file by analyzing their assembly language code, and we can do some manipulations on there to bypass the authentication or to find the correct registration code or serial number. Okay, I hope you like this video. Subscribe to our channel for getting some more awesome tutorials on ethical hacking, cyber security. Thank you. Bye.